Hey guys, it's me, Cam. Today's gonna be a little bit of a different video today. Unfortunately, as many of you know, the creator of Yu-Gi-Oh! The franchise, Kazuki Takahashi, unfortunately passed away. We, as a community, are very saddened to hear the news. We decided to celebrate his life by getting together, playing some Yu-Gi-Oh! Celebrating the creation that he's made, because without him, none of us would be here and hanging out. None of us would know each other. We owe all the good times that we've had experiencing the game, the show, the manga, anything to him. So out of respect for him and all the work that he's done, just wanted to make a little bit of a different video today. It's not going to be any gameplay or anything. We just wanted to just kind of share what Yu-Gi-Oh! Means to us. So I guess I'll go first by saying that aside from this game being something that I'm very passionate about, just the art, the gameplay, everything is just like very, very fun. Wouldn't have been able to have met any of these guys without the game or the franchise even existing. But over the last year or two, with the state of the world and COVID and everything since COVID, getting back into the game and really getting kind of passionate about it really kind of helped me through some tough times. So I really owe the world to Mr. Kazuki, and I'm really thankful that his creation was able to lift me and others out of some deep pits. Favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Memory? Honestly, the San Jose Regional was probably my favorite memory so far. Just being able to see, like, be there, 500 plus people all in a huge tournament, all competing, playing Yu-Gi-Oh! A lot of fun, meeting people from all over the world, just over, like, for the same love of the game, got to meet some cool people traveling from all over the country, different states coming into play. And then getting some food afterward, representing Santa Rosa, going with some guys. It was a really awesome experience. So that would be my favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Memory.
What Yu-Gi-Oh! Means to me is a pretty kick-ass game, because this is the game I would play like in high school. And actually, that's where I met a couple of my best friends over there. And it's just a nice gathering, just a nice community for the most part. Just like a nice escape from reality, from work, school, all that. I really love it. And yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh's just been a lifesaver for me, because me working like a long job, this is my hobby, and couldn't ask for a better game. Favorite memory of Yu-Gi-Oh would be, I think I played locals with my best friend in New Jersey. And I was about to play against this really good player that had Drytrons, and I had heroes. And if I had paired with him, I definitely would have lost. But because I dropped and I left a little early, I actually got second place and third place. I don't know how it worked, but I got like prizing, and then I left with like hella store credit, and I was like, I topped, and then I was just like, woo, I was totally fine with that. Like honestly, whenever I top a local somehow, it feels good. It always feels good. So like I would say, just spending time with all my friends out here, learning how to be a better player is always a good memory too. So shout out to Cam for just interviewing everybody like this during this sad week of losing the creator of the game. And I'm forever grateful for this Duel Monsters Yu-Gi-Oh! Game. So
my name is James Mesa, otherwise known as Kika in most online communities. I'm the main head judge and tournament organizer for the Santa Rosa and most of North Bay area. I've been playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Pretty much since the early 2000s. I've always been pretty much addicted to buying it and just playing it. It's always been super cool. I loved watching the anime growing up and just talking about it with my friends. Just Playground Yu-Gi-Oh! Has always been just one of my favorite ways to play. I love the game a lot. I think it's always been really fun. Every format is really interesting. Most formats are really interesting. I actually taught myself how to read and write with Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards. The game's always been a very positive impact on my life. I wouldn't know even like a fifth, like even I wouldn't know any of these people here if I didn't have this game in my life, and it gives me an outlet to get outside, do stuff, meet up with people, and make a whole lot of new friends. Probably like my favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Memory is back in around 2015-ish, the Secret Forces came out. That was the Necroz set in one of my favorite periods of the game ever, where Duelist Alliance was just running rampant. I pulled a Necroz of Brionic, which at the time was hitting 160, 170. I traded it to a friend for a bunch of staples and stuff and a Yosenju deck, and they had just gotten back from In-N-Out, so I traded it for one of their best, for one of their friends' lunch too. So I took his 4x4 from him on top of just like a bunch of good staples. So he had to go all the way back and get another burger.
I've been playing this game since the beginning, and my favorite moment is actually meeting all these people, because I started getting into this game not knowing anybody, and I was always the quiet type until I started going to a local card shop and realized just other people play the game. And I think at the time I was probably 13, 14, around that. And then even from now, the people who I used to play Yu-Gi-Oh! With, they're still my friends for over like 15 years. So to me, that's one of the best moments.
Growing up, my next door neighbor played Yu-Gi-Oh! With me. He was about like 4 years older than me, so I always looked up to him. It was super awesome. And when he got out, it was like right at the start of GOAT, what we call GOAT format. And he gave me a first edition Black Lester Soldier, like mint condition, bro. I still wish I had that, but just how much that meant to me was super awesome. And then second to that was just locals. We had a card shop in Rincon Valley called Cooperstown Cards and Comics. And dude, that place was so awesome. Just the feel of like biking down to your card shop on a Saturday morning, playing locals. Yeah, it was so cool, dude. You know, I never did great because I was super young, and but bro, it was so cool. It was awesome. And yeah, the community around this card game is so cool, so strong. It's really sad that we lost the creator, but. But you know, we play on in his memory, so that's really sick.
I'm very surprised that Yu-Gi-Oh! The community is still going strong. When I stopped playing, let's say about 5-6 years ago, because I got into Pokemon, because I thought everybody stopped. And then when I opened a shop, and I had a buddy, his name is Martin, he's like, "Yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is still doing well," and I'm really happy that the game that I first started with is still going on really, really good.
Did you watch the anime growing up?
Of course. Every Saturday morning, I always had to go watch the cartoon. How about yourself?
Oh, yeah, totally. What was your favorite anime moment? Can you think of one?
I don't know. Don't it's been way too long.
When Jack Atlas said, "Let it rip," and summoned Red Dragon Archfiend for the first time was the sickest episode I've ever watched the Yu-Gi-Oh! I fell in love with the series when Zane summoned Cyber Dragon for the first time, probably the coolest monster that I've ever seen. When the Secret Mechanic came out, Utopia first used its effect. When I first saw Red Dragon Nova, when I first saw Red Rising Dragon, like Yu-Gi-Oh!
I'm just gonna get
it. Oh, sorry, bro. Yeah. Oh, my bad.
Bro, like Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, I'm a kid from New Orleans, bro, so Yu-Gi-Oh! Has done a lot for me. I come from a place where it's very hard to make friends. It's very hard to socialize. You don't really have that many people that you can engage with. There's not a lot that brings people together, bro. Yu-Gi-Oh! Has probably been the only game that has pushed my thought process to the next level, bro. Has made me make business choices that I thought I would never make. Has made me make adult choices that I thought I'd never make. Has made me put trust in people that I thought I'd never put trust in. And it makes you do stuff differently, bro, because Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a game where, like I said, you get with your friends and you play, but you find out who your friends are. You find out who the people are that you sit down and you have conversations with, and that you use these dual monsters to engage with. Like, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is more than just a card game. It's a bridge for people to connect. It's something that we don't have. And It's cool. It's cool as all outdoors. Like, the TV show is amazing. The artwork is amazing. Like, I have posters of Galaxy Eyes. It's probably my favorite card. Most beautiful card in the game. Hands down. All of his Xyz. They're just gorgeous. Like, the game is amazing. And I said it before. I'm sorry, I'm kind of soft about it. But you guys are amazing, bro. Like, I love my group of friends. I love playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And I'm glad that Takahashi gave us this so that way we can enjoy each other.
So what's your phone?
That was beautiful, man. Favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Moment.
You were going hard.
My favorite moment in Yu-Gi-Oh! Entire favorite moment is when Kite summoned Neo Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon, and he told his opponent, "You could never defeat a god." That was the sickest moment in the anime. Because Kite wasn't even insane anymore. He was out of his brain. And he summoned the most beautiful neon dragon I'd ever seen in my life. And I was like, I'm a fanboy. Kaito forever.
About real life.
Best Yu-Gi-Oh! Moment in real life probably had to be... it was a regional I went to. I thought I lost my backpack. And a guy was literally walking through the venue looking for me. And he was like, bro, you can't come out here and sweat and not at least have fun. And I was like, yo, that's dope. You brought back my stuff. That's probably been my favorite moment inside of the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Just not knowing people and somebody being like, hey, you need these. These are cards. You got to play the game. So that's my favorite moment.